Now, the Copernican Revolution refers to the 16th century paradigm shift, which was named after the Polish mathematician and astronomer Nicholas Copernicus. So you have to remember this name kasi lumalabas ito sa LET examination. So Nicholas Copernicus is an important person who brought about the Copernican Revolution. And what is the Copernican Revolution? Well, it is because Copernicus formulated the heliocentric model of the universe. And from the name itself, this model of the universe is helio, meaning sun, centric, the center. So in simple terms, his view is that the universe revolves around the sun. Well, of course, right now we now know that it is not the sun that is the center of the universe, but rather the sun is the center of our solar system. So solar system lamang natin ang center ng ating sun. Well, actually there are new information that the sun is actually not the center, but the actual center is medyo off ng konti from the sun itself. So you can talk about that in astronomy, but these are new information. But at that time in the 16th century, ang pananaw ni Copernicus ay ang lahat ng mga bagay ay umiinog, umiikot sa araw kasama na ang mundo at iba pang mga planeta at mga bagay-bagay sa kalawakan. At that time, kung meron tayong heliocentric model which was proposed by Copernicus, the scientific theory o paniniwala that was set for several millennia is what we call as the geocentric model. Geo meaning earth, centric meaning center. So this model will be telling us that the earth is the center of the universe, or the planets at the least are revolving around the earth. And this is why this is widely espoused by Ptolemy. He's another scientist, astronomer at that time. So ito naman si Ptolemy, he backed the belief of previous scientists and philosophers that the earth is the center of the universe. Now, we cannot really fault Ptolemy and the previous astronomers, scientists, thinkers, philosophy, think that the earth is the center of the universe. Kasi kung tutusin talaga natin, experience-wise, we always see the sun going around us. So tayo, kung nakatayo tayo at obserbahan natin ang between, obserbahan natin ang buwan, obserbahan natin ang araw, it would really seem na talagang umiikot sila sa atin, or at least sa earth. So the sun will rise from the east, it will go towards the sky until noontime, sa pinakataas-taasan ng kalangitan, tapos naman bababa ito sa bandang west. So it would seem that it's really revolving around the earth. So we cannot really fault because this is an experiential observation. However, because of additional information, itong heliocentric model was proposed by Copernicus. So the idea that it is the sun and not the earth that is the center of the universe proved to be very unsettling in the beginning. The reason for that is because the heliocentric model was met with a huge resistance, primarily from the church, who accused Copernicus of being a heretic. The problem at that time ay ang paniniwala ng ruling religious organization, the church, ay ang pinakasentro ng kalawakan ay ang earth o ang mundo. Not only because it is experiential, but because it is a testimony written in the sacred scriptures. So the idea that it is not the earth and by extension not man that is the center of all creation proved to be very uncomfortable. Now if you look at the book of Genesis, the focus would be on the creation of man, and everything was created in order for man to live more comfortably, or at least ay mabuhay ng maayos. So that the focus of the religious atmosphere at that time is that man is the very center of creation and the very center of divine attention. Kaya noong pinropose ito ni Copernicus, it somehow follows that man is not the center of the universe, and by extension, that the center of man is not the center of creation as well. Kaya ito ay very, very uncomfortable in terms of the in the religious atmosphere at that particular time. Here's a picture of geocentric theory. The earth is in the middle, the moon is going around, and the sun is going around, the planets and even the stars are going around. But the heliocentric theory, at least the 16th century version, is that the sun is the center, while all the other planets will be going around them, and the earth with its moon going around it, around the earth, and you have all the stars at the background. So this is what the heliocentric theory would look like. The shift from geocentric to heliocentric was very, very slow, actually, and this has been contributed by several people. So you have to remember the name Tycho Brahe, kasi yung kanyang observation sa isang star by the name of Cassiopeia was very helpful to establish. Although by himself, he was not really able to prove the heliocentric model, but it was his assistant, Johannes Kepler, who made use of his data para mapatunayan, at least give evidence to the heliocentric theory. So one trivia, a very interesting story between Tycho Brahe and Johannes Kepler. According to many scholars, historical scholars, ay medyo hindi maganda ang relationship ni Tycho Brahe at saka ni Johannes Kepler. Tycho Brahe employed Johannes Kepler as his assistant, at sa pagtayo ng kanyang malaking astronomical observation, he was able to gather a lot of data, not only with Cassiopeia, even with the planet Mars and many other heavenly bodies. Pero nakita niya daw, at least ito yung sinasabi ng historical scholars, he was quite jealous about yung talino at saka kakayanan ni Johannes Kepler. So he kept all of his data away from his assistant. Kasi nakikita niya na darating ang time that Johannes Kepler will masasapawan siya, malalampasan siya ng kanyang assistant. But by some twist of fate, siya ay namatay. He died. And then all of his data, all of his research was napapunta kay Johannes Kepler. So, very interesting lamang itong mga side stories ng mga astronomers na ito. But in any case, Johannes Kepler made use of all of the data that Tycho Brahe left behind, and Johannes Kepler was able to discover that planets move in elliptical orbits and the sun as the center. Now, it's very interesting na ang planets ay nag-move in elliptical orbits kasi at that time, the scientific circle believed that everything would be the planets and the stars will be revolving in perfect circles because creation is perfect. So there is the religious influence on astronomical observations and astronomical thought. Kaya naniniwala mga siyentista noon, at least mga astronomers noon, na everything is perfect. Everything is from the orbit of the planets up to the face of the different planets. Everything should be very, very smooth and perfect. Pero Johannes Kepler, siya ay hindi, pinakita niya na hindi perfecto ang mga bagay na. So this was the first dent, or at least one of the first dents on the thought of the geocentric theory of perfectly orbiting planets or perfectly orbiting astronomical entities around the Earth. And later, Johannes Kepler said that the sun is the center of the universe. So it was Galileo Galilei who gave more of the evidence that indeed the sun is the center of the universe. Ang ginawa ni Galileo Galilei ay kanyang itinutok ang kanyang telescope, he observed Venus, and he was able to take note of several phases, changes in Venus, yung lighted area. So he was able to, he thought that this changes in the phases of the lighted side of Venus is not possible if the Venus would be going around the Earth. It's only possible if the planet Venus would be going around the Sun. So, yan ang kanyang observation. In addition to that, although it's not written here, he also observed Jupiter, and he noticed that there were a lot of mini planets, which we now call as moons. There are a lot of circular objects going around the planet. So this is another important bent on geocentric theory, which proposed everything revolves around the Earth. But it seemed Galileo was able to show na hindi pa ito totoo, kundi even in the planet Jupiter may umiinag, may umiikot mismo sa planetang Jupiter and not sa planetang Earth. So this is one of the important contribution that helped in the pavement of the heliocentric theory. And finally, Sir Isaac Newton's law of gravitation. So napakita ng law na ito na two bodies will always be attracting each other due to gravity. And he was also able to show that because of the sun's gravity, the Earth is and the other planets are actually revolving around. The Earth does not have enough mass para paikutin ang mga planeta sa kanya, but the sun has the capacity dahil napakalaki talaga ng kanyang mass, yung kanyang amount, yung kanyang substansya, that the sun is able to attract all of the planets and let them go around the sun. Okay. The contribution of the Copernican Revolution is until today very far-reaching. It served as a catalyst to sway scientific thinking away from age-long views about the position of the Earth relative to an enlightened understanding of the universe. So sa pamamagitan ng paradigm shift na ito, we are now able to, kumbaga eh, dati nakatutok lamang tayo sa Earth and how ito umiikot sa ating mundo, but now because of the new understanding and new information that the Earth is not the center of the universe, so lumawak yung ating pananaw o lumawak yung ating paningin, so that we are now veering beyond the Earth, beyond the solar system, and that helped to produce our modern astronomy. So sa ngayon, tayo ay meron na tayong marami ng mga naimbento na teleskopyo, some even are satellites orbiting around the Earth na ito ay nakatutok sa kalawakan. We have now veered very, very far away, millions of miles away from us. Napakalayo na. Kaya nakita na natin ng iba't ibang mga galaxies, nakita natin ng iba't ibang mga heavenly bodies that are very, very far away, that are at the far reaches of the visible universe. And I say visible kasi ang ating kakayanan lamang ay hanggang doon lang makita ang kalawakan. But very, very sure, scientists are very sure that the universe is even bigger than what we are able to observe with our present instruments. So ito ay naging catalyst para mapalitan ang thinking na yan. And now we have the modern thinking or the modern scientific thinking about our universe. This marked the beginning of the modern astronomy. It influenced changes in cosmology. Pag sinabing cosmology, ito ay ang pag-aaral ng kalawakan, the study of the birth or the origin of the universe, even changes in the religion, physics, and even in philosophy. It changed the belief of the people about the placement of the Earth. So yun ang pinaka-primary, kung saan nakalagay ang Earth. It's not in the center, but actually one of the planets that will be revolving around the sun in our